Welcome to the Eyes on the Sky series, an update about current astronomy, space science, and sky events. I'm Hudson Valley Community College astronomer Richard Monda, and this is Eyes on the Sky for September 2018. During the night of September 1st, around 1 a.m. in the east, the 20-day-old waning gibbous moon is approaching the constellation of Taurus the Bull. By the 2nd, the moon is well into Taurus, and on the 3rd, the moon appears near Aldebaran, the constellation's brightest star. On the 4th, the moon, now just past third quarter, appears on the easternmost side of Taurus. Soon before the sun comes up on the morning of September 7th, Regulus, the brightest star of Leo the Lion, is rising before Mercury, and both appear low in the eastern horizon about a half hour before sunrise. Above the two objects is a thin lunar crescent. The next morning, this trio of celestial objects appears close to one another. New moon happens at 2:01 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time on September 9th. Then, soon after sunset on the 10th, a very thin waxing lunar crescent is only 4 degrees above the western horizon. That's less than the view through standard 7x50 binoculars. The next evening, a slightly more illuminated crescent is roughly at the same altitude as Venus, as well as near the same altitude as Spica, Virgo's brightest star. Venus has gotten low in our evening sky, but it will continue to brighten all month. At the beginning of September, a telescope shows Venus as a fat crescent. By mid-month, its crescent shape is slimming, but the planet is growing in apparent size because the distance between Earth and Venus is currently decreasing. September will be the last full month to see Venus. Then, very early in October, Venus will disappear from our evening sky, only to reappear before dawn as the morning star in the east during mid-November. On September 12th, the lunar crescent is above Venus in the west-southwest, as the moon starts its week-long trek by the four naked-eye planets that are now in the evening sky. On the 13th, the waxing crescent moon is near Jupiter. Then it's to the east of this giant planet on the 14th. By September 15th, the widening lunar crescent is over Scorpius and its bright reddish star Antares. Antares is one of the largest stars known. It's classified as a red supergiant star. If the sun could be replaced with Antares, this star would extend past the orbit of Mercury, Venus, Earth, and even Mars. And Mars is 140 million miles away from the sun on average. The first quarter moon occurs on September 16th when it appears west of Saturn. On the 17th, the moon, now in its waxing gibbous phase, is to the east of the ring planet. And by the evening of September 19th, the moon appears near Mars, where it has entered the fall constellation of Capricornus the Seagoat. Luna then glides through the rest of Capricornus over the next 2 days. Autumn occurs at 9:54 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time on September 22nd, when the sun's path across the sky is halfway between its high and low extremes. Last month, NASA launched a space probe to touch the sun. The 7-year Parker Solar Probe mission will fly through the sun's corona, the outer atmosphere of the sun that is only visible during a total solar eclipse. This spacecraft will try to answer the solar astronomy problem of why the corona is more than 100 times hotter than the sun's surface. The last few days of September see the moon back in Taurus. On September 28th, by 11 p.m., the waning gibbous moon is in the east. The next night, it's over the east-northeast when it appears very close to Aldebaran. Finally, on the last day of September, the moon rises about 10:30 p.m. and is still low in the sky by 11. I'm Hudson Valley Community College astronomer Richard Monda, reminding you to keep your eyes on the sky.